Camera A, camera B speeding.
Sound speed, all devices on. Start, please.
Okay, Danielle, can you talk us through that day you were feeling all that pain?
I mean, I knew it was serious because I've never felt this ever in my life. I didn't know if I was having a heart attack. I literally felt like my arm was gonna literally like explode. Like that's what it felt like inside. You instantly just think about your kids. That instantly just rushes in your head. Like I still have a lot of life that I want to live with them. And am I not gonna be able to do that anymore? Adam's like, I need to get you to the emergency room. So he calls Ashley and she's like, drop the girls off at the house, y'all go. And so we left right then and there. I remember going to the emergency room and you just think, what am I doing wrong that is allowing this to happen to my body? They hooked me up to some fluids and took an EKG and I'm still having a horrible migraine all through this whole time. I mean, the emergency room, it didn't give me much answers. It, you know, left me with, you know, you're okay in this moment. We've, like, did what we can. You're safe to go home. But these migraines and numbness and heaviness and, you know, the pains and the weird, like, all that stuff is still here every single day. You know, it took that moment for me to have the moment to say, I got to figure this out so that I can be better. And that's where this is going. Like, gotta get better.
I wanna go to the seaside. Park or not too fast. Oh, I'm going. Can you give that one to me?
Despite everything going on, both Adam and I just wanna keep everything as normal as we can for the girls. And even though the pain that I've been feeling hasn't gone away, I mean, most days I can fight through it.
All right, nobody's gonna ride bikes.
All right, Riley, you're almost six. We need to knock out learning how to ride a bike. Yeah.
Say, we don't need no stinking training wheels.
You and Daddy go practice. We've been working with the girls for months on bike riding without training wheels, and it's had its ups and downs.
But I feel like they're close to ditching those training wheels for good.
Remember, you just keep pedaling, and when you feel like you have to stop, do you remember what to do?
Yeah, I do that.
Just put your foot out.
Okay.
You ready?
Rock and roll. Go.
All right, remember what I said. Watch where you're going. You're doing good.
It's hard to learn to ride a bike. You only could fall on the grass, but not on the concrete. You hear the big scratch.
Now start pedaling. Pedal, 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 pedal.
Look at Riley.
What?
Go, Riley. Keep pedaling.
Go, go, go.
Keep going. Look at her, Lulu.
Just keep pedaling.
And catch yourself.
Good job. Give me a high five. Look at this girl.
I mean, Riley just jumped on the bike and just took off. She was just gone.
Who's next on the bike? Come on.
Come on.
And then Parker's like right behind her.
Go, Parker.
Mommy, look.
Keep going.
And then Olivia.
Go, Lulu, find
go.
Your balance.
Keep pedaling.
Go, go.
I mean, Ava's probably a little bit further behind the other three.
Keep pedaling. Got you. And then there's Hazel.
Whee! Good job, Hazel.
You're okay.
Woo! Shake it off. Shake it off.
Look at me. What'd you hit?
You did super good.
You had to practice.
There, you're good. Don't let this bike win. Get back on that bike. Tell this bike who's boss.
I like the training wheels on because it's easier to ride.
Ooh, that made me dizzy.
I don't want you running yourself raggedy just with everything that you've had going on.
I mean, we pretty much got them all riding. I mean, they're all doing well.
Yeah, I know. I wasn't even the one running around with the quints, but I still got worn out. And I don't like that because I want to be part of all these milestones with the girls, but sometimes my body just won't let me.
Hello, pretty boy. This is real makeup.
Hey, picked up food.
Hey.
I'm gonna start making some plates.
You ready to eat?
Yeah, I mean, it took forever.
How was the stuff at the doctor? What is that?
Came home with a heart monitor.
Huh?
At least it's not connected to a wire in a box and it's gonna beep all night.
That just like sticks to you? Or is there something actually like sticking in your skin?
No, it's just stick. I guess these are measuring my heart rate.
I mean, seeing Danielle wearing this heart monitor for the first time, you can't help but not be like taken back by it a little bit, just because it definitely makes it a lot more real that this could potentially be something wrong with her heart.
I will bring it back next week. Whoa. And then follow up with the doctor and they'll download what it records and then we'll go over all the results together.
It's kind of crazy to see you like wearing a heart monitor.
I know, I was like the youngest person in that whole building. The stress test came back fine and the heart monitor came back fine. But he said, remember I was trying to explain to you the bubbles? And so he was telling me that, you know, they did go through and you could see him on the other side and you're not supposed to. He said, so there's probably like 7-9 bubbles that are in this chamber that shouldn't be there. So I did a echocardiogram, which is basically an ultrasound of your heart. But they wanted to do a bubble study echocardiogram. So they put an IV and they inject saline with air. It takes about 5 seconds for it to get to your heart. I was looking at it and I was like, what's that up there? And he's like, that's the bubbles. I was like, oh, look, there's the bubbles. That's cool, you can see the bubbles. But you're not supposed to see it on the left side of your heart.
And so he called it, there's two things it can be, PFO or ASD. If it's a PFO, you don't necessarily have to close it and fix it. But if it's an ASD, we need to close it. So I was like,
ASD, atrial septal defect, it could lead to more issues as far as like strokes or whatever. So then he's kind of saying, do you feel like you've ever had a stroke? And I was like, I was in the freaking emergency room because I thought I was having a heart attack. So that scares me.
Well, he said it could just be a hole in your heart. It could be 3 holes in your heart. No, he said he doesn't want to speculate until he does the test. You know, so maybe what happened and I went to the emergency room has to do with this, and it is the ASD. You know, I don't want it to be something that I have to go close.
I'm mom of 6, for God's sake. Like, what is that going to do? You know, that's my scare, is that if I have to have surgery, like, what is it? It's already hard enough for me to just stop on a day-to-day basis, much less if you have to have heart surgery. That's intense to me. That's like as bad as it could get.
I'm 36 years old.
You know?
So just throwing me off that it's like possibly have to have heart surgery kind of thing, you know, like.